when it comes to halal and haram, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to follow the rule outlined in Surah Maida, ayat number 87. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu la tuhadimu tayyibati ma ahallallahu lakum wa la ta'tadu inna Allah la yuhibbul mu'tadin. O you who believe, do not prohibit the good things which Allah has made lawful to you, and do not transgress. Indeed, Allah does not like transgressors. So the general principle is that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made something halal, you cannot make it haram upon yourself. Now there are three possibilities for you to make something haram upon yourself. First is that you are clearly aware something is halal, and yet you hold the belief that it is haram, it is impermissible. This is a huge sin and could lead to kufr. Second possibility is that you do not consider it haram, but take an oath unnecessarily to ban it upon yourself. This is also sinful and will require you to break the oath and pay kafara. There could be a situation where you had to take an oath out of necessity, in which case such oath is permissible but undesirable. And the third situation is that you neither believe it haram nor take an oath to ban it upon yourself, but make a resolution to abandon it. If you leave it with the intention of reward, then this could be innovation and sinful, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not declare that you abstain yourself from this thing, and that is an act of worship or an act of reward. So if you make that intention yourself, then it would be innovation. However, if you leave it for a particular medical or spiritual goal, then it is permissible. So if someone decides that they would not be eating a particular type of fruit because it is high in sugar, and that's something he would avoid forever in his life, that's a resolution he has in his mind, and he follows it, then there is no harm. He's doing it for a valid reason. Or sometimes to train your body about resisting the temptation, you decide, let's say chocolate is something that, you know, you get cravings on. So you decide you will stop eating chocolate to control your temptation and your own desires. Then again, you're doing it for a purpose, and this is acceptable.